Prevalent problems intensified by the COVID-19 pandemic persist along RTD's transit lines, including the hub at Union Station.
Is it easy to find drugs here?
Oh, yeah.
Over the last few years, the problem solvers exposing rampant drug use, drug paraphernalia, unsanitary conditions, and
think about that, bro, for this bus. Shut up.
Countless violent assaults.
And at one point, he had his thumb in my eye socket. My eyes started to come off.
Numerous operators put in situations fearing for their lives.
Quit spitting on me.
They just want protection. They just want to feel safe coming to work, doing their job, and going home.
In February, a large police operation resulted in the arrest of 42 people, pressure mounting for things to change.
RTD is pursuing a myriad of initiatives, both short, mid, and long term.
Earlier this year, new initiatives announced to crack down, including an increase in security, making officers more visible.
We still have a ways to go. We still have issues that need to be addressed.
Ronald Short, vice president of the union and veteran bus operator, says it's a step in the right direction, but shared one of his operators was just assaulted this morning. The Fox 31 digital data desk tracking RTD's calls of service. Take a look. A spike in March and a peak in May, but the numbers show a decline in calls at Union Station, but still frequent calls on the light rail.
Now it's a migration, and the bad elements are using the system to migrate to other reaches of the metro area.
RTD's transit police chief Robert Grado resigned in March, and that's when Steve Martingano was appointed to serve as interim chief. But tomorrow, after a national search, someone will be appointed chief.
They do have a daunting task. Compassion for the employees and the public at large, and then just strength and character.